The second half of 2023 is about to begin, and the beginning of every month, I go through a bunch of sneaker releases for that month and play double up, buy once or pass. And the concept is simple. If I love a shoe, I give it a double up. If I like but don't love, I give it a buy once and pass. That's self-explanatory. And for June, I gotta say June is looking bleak. May was such a strong month, at least for me. I really, really liked a lot of pairs of shoes in May. In comparison, there's probably only one or two pairs of shoes on this list that I love. There's a lot I like, but not many that I love. However, you should still stick around and watch this video because maybe you disagree with me and I'd love to hear your opinion. Here we go. First up is the Air Jordan 1 Zoom Comfort 2 Teyana Taylor, A Rose from Harlem. And if you didn't know, Teyana Taylor, a singer, actor, celebrity, a Zoom Comfort 2 is essentially a modified Air Jordan 1. So it has a Zoom Air unit instead of a normal Nike Air unit. It has extra ventilation on the side of the shoe. It also has Formula 23 foam, which is a pretty modern technology for Nike. So it's more lightweight and responsive than, say, polyurethane. And it also has a more rigid and tightened down midfoot. Now, all that is supposed to make this shoe more comfortable, hence the name Comfort 2. However, I personally own one pair of Zoom Comfort 2s. I really don't feel like it's more comfortable. Don't know if it's just me, I maybe need to wear it more, but honestly, I prefer the Jordan 1s. The pair I got that felt stiff, the cushioning wasn't noticeably better, I just didn't like it, and I don't really love the extra ventilation that you see on the side of the shoe. And according to Nike.com's description, this shoe celebrates anyone who's had to overcome struggles. And the whole theme is roses out of the concrete, and the black, red, and white is a tribute to Teyana Taylor's Trinidad heritage. And there's a ton of details on this shoe. There's mismatched swooshes on each shoe, so one shoe comes with zigzags around the swoosh, and the swoosh extends all the way into the midsole. Now the other shoe, you see these thorns coming out of the swoosh, of course to play into that rose out of the concrete theme, and they've gone ahead and replaced the normal ventilation pattern with X's all over the shoe. Now the box of the shoe is also printed with the words, "Out of the concrete grew a rose." Now that is a tribute to the legend Tupac, who is obviously synonymous with the West Coast rap scene. However, he was born in Harlem, just like Teyana Taylor. And personally, Tupac is probably my favorite rapper ever, so I love that tribute. And further playing into this whole theme of a rose coming out of the concrete, on one flap of the ankle collar, it says "a rose," and the other one, it says "from Harlem." And finally, to cap it off, there's a huge gold rose debris on the shoe. I don't really love that debris. I feel like it's way too much. It's way too big. It's pretty overpowering. It's a cool collectible though, but I would never ever wear it on the shoe. Now, some people have pointed out that the colorway of the shoe kind of reminds them of a Ronald McDonald shoe. However, personally, I kind of like it. I like all the kind of modifications and the theme of the shoe and the storytelling on the shoe. I don't really love that they use this silhouette, but overall, the storytelling, I really, really appreciate. And even though I do get the reference to Ronald McDonald, especially with that yellow, I do like the black and white. So with all that said, I'm gonna give this shoe a buy once. Also dropping on June 1st for $150 is the KD15 50 Years of Hip Hop. Now Nike's been celebrating 50 years of hip hop lately. One example of that is the Air Force One Atlanta, and they also had the Nike Dunk Low in the same colorway for Atlanta. I was able to get that shoe, really like that shoe, and there's a whole bunch of Air Force Ones that's slated to come out sometime in 2023. That's supposed to be part of the same 50 Years of Hip Hop collection. And on June 1st, they're adding the KD15 silhouette to that collection. It's kind of weird because Nike.com, the description on the website, never even mentions hip-hop, which is insane to me because literally on the tongue, in a very retro vintage type of feel, it literally says 50 years of hip-hop. So it's obviously part of the collection, but in the description, it's like they fail to mention it. I don't get it. Now the colorway of the shoe, it's a very simple smoke gray and black with kind of this beachy color. Really like the colorway, and overall I do like the KD15s. I think it's a pretty good silhouette, especially for a basketball shoe. You can probably wear it casually if you really wanted to. My favorite part of the shoe is, at least judging from images, the parts that are leather. So you see right on the ankle collar, it looks to be tumbled leather. And on the heel of the shoe, it says Easy with S replaced by a dollar sign. Obviously a reference to Kevin Durant's nickname, Easy Money Sniper. And this shoe also comes with a microphone as a hang tag. Again, way too big, would never wear the shoe, but awesome for a collectible. Now, as a huge fan of hip hop and someone that likes the KD15 silhouette, also really likes this colorway, I am gonna give this a buy once. However, definitely not a double up because I just feel like it's a bit limited in the ways you can wear this shoe. Dropping on June 6th for $140 is the Air Max 1 Puerto Rico. Now this is actually a pack of two Air Max 1s, and I don't think the release date is confirmed yet, but I'm gonna include it in this list because I do love the Air Max 1. And I think this is a pretty cool pack. And you see one shoe is predominantly light blue and the other one is orange, peachy type of color. So one cold and one warm colorway. Now these MX ones are inspired by piragua, which is a Puerto Rican shaved ice dessert. So usually it comes in these very colorful colors. And you see the piragua inspiration on the tongue of each shoe, with each colorway having a slight different graphic on the tongue. However, there are some commonalities between the two shoes. Both come with that jeweled swoosh instead of a normal Air Max 1 swoosh, as well as identical lace to braids that says Puerto Rico. I really like that touch, but one thing that I don't love about both shoes is the color of that base layer. It's like this sandy type of color, I can't really quite describe it. I just don't think it fits well with the orangey, peachy, and blue color. I think white would have been better, and I would have preferred white leather instead of what looks like textile on this shoe. The Air Max 1 is my favorite Air Max, and I think these are pretty clean colorways. But if I had to choose one, I'd probably just choose the blue colorway. I feel like the peachy, orangey color is a bit out of my norm, so I'd give that a pass, but I'd give the blue colorway a buy once. Next up, dropping on June 7th for $150, is the Air Force 1 LA. Now, similar to the KD15s on this list, this shoe seems to also celebrate 50 years of hip hop. Obviously, LA is a huge influential city. Now, according to Nike.com, the upper sole of the shoe is made out of denim, which is supposed to represent the grit of the West Coast. Now, I'm not sure if grit is the first thing I think about when I see a denim shoe, but I guess that's their interpretation of denim. Now, the most distinct thing about the shoe is obviously the LA that's stitched on the heel of the shoe. And the really cool thing about that is you see the swoosh that kind of goes through LA. I really like that touch, but that's not my favorite thing about this shoe. As an old man, my favorite thing about this shoe is the gum bottoms. I love gum bottoms, and especially on the Air Force One, I just think it really fits that silhouette. The shoe also looks to have a plush ankle collar, which gives it a more premium and luxurious feel. And even though I don't like denim shoes, I prefer leather, suede, nubuck, which are all forms of leather. I do really like hip hop, I love the gum bottoms, I like the ankle collar. I think that LA stitching with the swoosh going through it is pretty cool. So I'm gonna give this shoe a buy once. Next up, dropping on June 7th for $125, is one of the legendary OGs in my opinion. It is the Air Flight Huarache. Now this varsity purple and royal blue colorway is an OG colorway. Now this shoe originally debuted in 1992 and it was made famous by the Fab Five, which if you didn't know was the basketball team for the Michigan Wolverines. I believe 4 out of those 5 players made it to the NBA. The most famous player to make it to the NBA, probably Chris Webber and then Jalen Rose, who obviously does a lot of commentary. And the Fab Five, when they were playing, they were just the coolest team in basketball, including the NBA. They were known for wearing baggy shorts, wearing black socks, which was a rare thing back in the day. And as someone that only wears black socks, I definitely appreciate them setting that trend. And the Air Flight Huarache is just one of the most distinct silhouettes ever. You see that very, very unique caging around the ankle collar? And the booty of the shoe is made out of neoprene. Now, Tinker Hatfield, who was the co-designer of this shoe, he was inspired by a water skiing trip when he was wearing water skiing boots made out of neoprene, and he really was impressed with the snugness and fit of the shoe, so he decided to incorporate that into the Air Flight Huaraches. And notice how there was no swoosh branding on this shoe, and it was just a very, very unique looking shoe. I love how it looks, but my favorite thing about the shoe is probably the outsole. You see that little green color? That kind of stands out, that kind of maybe doesn't fit in that well, but it just has this very 90s retro vibe to it. I love it. Now, according to Nike.com, even though the specs of the shoe are made close to the 1992 original version, however, they did update the technology, so it does feature Nike Air units, both in the forefoot as well as the heel. Now, I remember when I was super young, there was this dude I knew who had this shoe, who would wear it everywhere, and I was just so jealous. I wanted this shoe so bad, I never got it. However, this time, I'm definitely gonna give this a double up. Next up, also dropping on June 7th for $160, is the Air Max 1 The Bay. Now, similar to the Air Force 1 LA, this shoe also is a tribute to a certain location, obviously the Bay Area in Northern California instead of Southern California this time. And according to Nike.com's description, it's to celebrate the eclectic style going up and down Highway 101. Now, this shoe looks to feature an all-white leather base layer. And again, according to Nike.com, they use a bunch of different textures on this shoe to represent that eclectic style of the Bay Area. And of course, the most distinct feature about this shoe is that red swoosh that looks to be a feather. And I think it actually looks pretty cool. I think it's pretty unique. It's pretty different. I like that creativity. The swoosh on the inside of the shoe, however, looks to be in that snakeskin or at least faux snakeskin textured material. Now, I usually don't love that, but I get what the shoe is trying to do, trying to use as many materials as possible. There's also this fur that starts from the bottom of the tongue. I really, really don't like that. I just don't love the look of fur on shoes. I don't think it's going to do well in the rain or snow, but you know, if you're from the Bay Area, you don't need to worry about rain or snow. But overall, I just don't like how they included that fur. I feel like it's just one too many materials. Now, the tongue is also modified to say the Bay. And on the insole of the shoe, one says the Bay, the other says Nike Coast. I like that. I like how it comes in that license plate shape. It's hard for me to pass on Air Max 1s, especially one that has some creativity to the shoe. And even though I don't like that fur, I do like how simple and clean this shoe looks to be, especially from a distance. If I could, I would like cut out the fur. I probably wouldn't do a good job of it, but I would try and remove it. And then I think it would be a super, super clean shoe. So with all that said, I'm gonna give this shoe a buy once. Next up, releasing on June 8th for $180 is a women's exclusive, the Air Jordan 5 Low Indigo Haze. Now the colorway of the shoe is out there. It's super out there. I'm not a huge fan of purple. I like it in hints or like accents or like compliments to a all white or all black shoe. But with this full upper sole looking to be purple, I don't know if I'm the person to pull it off. I love Jordan 5s, even the lows. That's my favorite silhouette in general. But this is a lot. This is definitely a lot. Now Nike does mention an all out reflectivity when the party goes late into the night. So I'm guessing this whole upper sole is made out of that 3M material that reflects when you turn the lights off. And on the ankle collar, you see that color that Nike calls alabaster, which is obviously a type of rock. And I can see that it does look like that color, but this purple, I don't know what I could wear with. I just don't know if I could ever pull it off. Love Jordan 5s, but I don't think this one's for me. So I'm gonna give this shoe a pass. Next up, releasing on June 9th for $160 is the Bodega and New Balance 610, The Trail Less Taken. Now, Bodega is a shop in Boston that has done a bunch of collaborations with sneaker companies throughout the years. And this shoe is actually inspired by a pigeon keeper whose real name is Hubert, but who goes by Live Action. He's from Brooklyn. And the main message of this shoe and why using Live Action as the inspiration is that you should do whatever you want regardless of what anyone else thinks. And there's a bunch of colors on the shoe. So I see predominantly black and gray, but then you also see hints of blue, as well as purple and a bit of yellow. And apparently all these colors are supposed to pay tribute to the bird's feathers and overall feel. The shoe also has speed lace locks, which apparently is a given for a trail running shoe. And I do like the main message they're going for. I do think it's cool to be authentic, cool to just do what you love, no matter what other people think about your hobby, about your passion. So I really like that message. However, I have said before, even though New Balance is all the rage, all the hype nowadays, I just can't really get into a lot of their silhouettes. I think the 550 is the only silhouette that I genuinely like. All the other ones just still look too much like running shoes for me. I've never gone for a run in my entire life. The only time I've ran is in the context of sport, so I've never really liked that aesthetic. And it's the same with this shoe. The 610 is a shoe that was made for trail running, and as someone that's never done that and has no interest to do it, I just don't love the look of this shoe. So despite really supporting that authentic message of just owning your passions, owning what you really love to do, just looking at the shoe by itself, I just can't do it. I'm gonna have to give this shoe a pass. Next up, dropping on June 10th for $180 is the Air Jordan 1 Black and Smoke Gray. Now, I think some people will refer to this shoe as washed black or washed heritage. I'm saying black and smoke gray because that's what it says on sneakers. Now, this is the second shoe of 2023 to go for that washed aesthetic. The first one, I believe it was the washed pink that I reviewed. I really liked that shoe. I really liked that washed aesthetic overall. I do think that kind of vintage, pre-aged vibe is kind of played out. But this washed feel, I really, really like. And obviously Jordan Brand on the Jordan 1 specifically, they've done this before with the Jordan 1 Turbo Greens. That is a really, really nice shoe. But I think this colorway, as someone that really likes black, white, and gray, very simple, I think this one might be the best out of all of them. That might be controversial to say because I know a lot of people love that turbo green. I think this is my favorite, even over the wash pink that I really, really like. Now, just like the wash pink, this shoe features a white base leather layer with suede overlays. And even though I really like that white and washed gray combination, my favorite thing about this shoe are just the hints of red. It just makes it pop. It just really goes well with these two colors. I love it. I love this shoe. It's probably my favorite one on this list. So as you can guess, I'm going to give this shoe a double up. Also dropping on June 10th for $125 is the Terminator High University Red and White. Now the Nike Terminator, if you didn't know, it came out in 1985 and it was the first Nike signature school shoe. And the first school that was lucky enough to pair up with Nike was Georgetown. And the Terminator Georgetown actually retroed in 2022, or was it maybe the beginning of this year? I'm getting the 2 years mixed up, but I retroed very recently. I didn't go for that shoe. And the main reason is I just don't love this silhouette. I know the Terminator has its fans and it was big back in the 80s, but I look at the shoe like I look at cars. I generally like more European sports cars, which has more curves, it just looks a bit more sleek, rather than more American sports cars, which usually go for a more boxy, more angular shape. And this Terminator, especially from the ankle collar down to the rest of the shoe, it just looks too angular for me. I don't love how it just goes straight down. Don't love it. I can't really put my finger on it. I just don't love the shape. And not to mention that university red in such large amounts, I just think it's too bright. It's just too much. So the combination of those two factors, I'm gonna give this shoe a pass. Speaking of the Terminator High, coming up on June 13th for $120, it's the Terminator Low Michigan. Now, Michigan was one of the original seven schools that partnered up with Nike. I think that Michigan colorway is probably the second or third best college colorway in my opinion. I think the best is UNC, and then it's Georgetown, and then probably Michigan. I love that navy, I love that yellow, I love both of them together. Now, this shoe features an all-leather base layer, and I do think the low version of the shoe is probably better than the highs. I just think it's a lot more wearable than the highs, but I can't get over the silhouette. I don't know what it is. Maybe I just need to buy a pair and it'll look way better in hand. I'll just like it when I see them. It's like the airships. It wasn't until I got the Dune Red airships that I really liked that silhouette. So maybe I just need to give this a go. But right now, even though I love this colorway, as of right now, I'm gonna give this shoe a pass. Next up on June 16th for $150 is the Air Jordan 2 Low Cherrywood. Yes, the Jordan 2 is not stopping anytime soon, and according to Nike.com, this shoe will only be available in neighborhood stores in North America. So if you're looking for the shoe, it seems to be rather limited. It's a white leather-based layer with suede overlays. The Cherrywood, I think it looks pretty nice. It's a very simple colorway, and it looks very, very clean. And despite how clean this shoe is, I do really like that Cherrywood color. I just think there's been too many Jordan 2s lately. And unless there's some great story behind the shoe, like at least the UNC to Chicago Jordan 2 lows, at least there's a cool story behind it, and you know the theme behind that shoe, I just think there's nothing too unique or special about this particular Jordan 2 low. So with that said, I'm gonna give this shoe a pass. Next up on June 23 for $140 is the Air Jordan 1 low black cement elephant print. Now this is pretty much the sibling to the Air Jordan 1 High White Cement Elephant Print. That shoe, I've talked about that shoe before in the previous months, double up, buy once, or pass. And I said in that video, all that elephant print is just doing too much. My opinion, and my humble opinion, the elephant print is supposed to be an accent. It's supposed to complement a shoe. It cannot be the main feature of the shoe. And I say the same thing about this shoe. This shoe features an all black nubuck base layer. And the black actually makes the elephant print stand out even more. So you actually notice it more, and it just feels so messy. There's just too much of it. Now, I do know people that like this shoe. The more elephant print, the better. And I totally respect your opinion. But personally, for me, I cannot. It's just too much. Just overdone. Just everything about the shoe just kind of grosses me out. I can't do it. I'm definitely giving this shoe a pass, pass, pass. And finally, to round out this list, on June 30th for $200, is the Air Jordan 7 White Infrared. That infrared is pretty much a legendary color from Nike. And on the Jordan 7s, I think it's a very, very clean shoe. The Jordan 7s usually come with pretty nice leather, and with the hints of infrared, it just looks really nice. However, a personal problem for me, just like the Jordan 6, as a wide footer, the Jordan 7s do not look good on my feet. When I look down from a bird's eye view, because I have wide feet, the silhouette of the Jordan 7, it's more narrow. So even if I go up half a size and it fits well internally, when I look down at my feet, the spillover from my feet, I can't take it. It's like wearing Chuck Taylors. I don't wear Chuck Taylors because I can see my fat feet just spilling out. It just grosses myself out. I don't like it. And the Jordan 6 and the Jordan 7, even though I do like those silhouettes, in vacuum, I was just not born to be a Jordan 6 and Jordan 7 guy. I do have one pair of Jordan 7s currently. It is the Jordan 7 Cardinal. Couldn't pass on those. Those are just too historically significant. And this shoe, even though I really like the colorway, for my own sanity, for my own shallowness, I've got to give this shoe a pass. That's it. Thanks for watching Soul Inclined. Let me know what shoes on this list you would double up on, which shoes you think are just trash and would definitely pass on. Like, subscribe, comment, all that good stuff. And remember, tomorrow may never come, so wear your shoes.